I am Gabriel Sanfélix, Head of the Health Services Research Unit of Fisabio, Valencia, and I have the pleasure to introduce you to our study entitled Effect of Cost Sharing on Adherence to ACS-based Medications in Patients After an Acute Coronary Syndrome, recently published in Heart. Evidence in other settings suggests that subjecting essential medications to patient cost sharing in high-risk populations may affect medication adherence and consequently compromise achievements shown in clinical trials. In spite of this, in July 2012, the pharmaceutical cost-sharing scheme changed in Spain. This change affected pensioners who were exempt from cost-sharing and had an increase of 10% with different monthly savings depending on income. This change also affected middle to high-income working population who had an increase from 40% to 50 or 60% depending on income. However, low-income working population had their coinsurance unchanged at 40%. These differential cost-sharing schemes resulted in a natural experiment with the latter group acting as a control group and the pensioners and middle to high-income working populations as intervention groups. This provided us an opportunity to evaluate the consequences of increase on drug cost-sharing on adherence in patients of high risk after an acute coronary syndrome.
We studied a population-based retrospective cohort of patients discharged alive after an acute coronary syndrome in any hospital of the region of Valencia, Spain, from January 2009 to December 2011. Our primary outcome is weekly adherence. We obtained a repeated dichotomous measure for each week of follow-up and patient. We constructed weekly series of adherence proportions for the intervention and control cohorts from 18 months before the cost-sharing policy change and 18 months after, that is 156 weeks. With differences models, we estimated the short-term immediate effect and the medium-term effect for each medicine, comparing the control group with each intervention group. Weekly rates of adherence for the four therapeutic groups before and after the scheme change are shown in this figure. For the whole period, adherence rates in the pensioners group were higher than for the two working population groups for all therapies. Among the working population, middle to high income patients had better adherence than low income patients, even before the change of the cost sharing. According to the model estimation, the cost sharing change had an immediate effect on the pensioner group as compared with the control group for the two medications of higher cost. For the middle to high income group as compared to the control group, only adherence to statins significantly decreased after the reform. No effect was found for low price essential medications, antiplatelet and beta blockers, in either intervention group as compared with the control group.
Hi, this is Aníbal García from the Health Services Research Unit in Fisabio in Valencia, and I will summarize for you now the key learnings and takeaways arising from our study. First, we obtained improved adherence estimates using another approach in which we link prescription and dispensation data. Using this improved outcome measure, we found a detrimental effect of increasing drug out-of-pocket expenses of patients to evidence-based medication adherence in a cohort of high-risk patients and in a universal coverage healthcare setting. According to those results, we conclude that consideration should be given to fully exempting high-risk patients from drug cost-sharing. Finally, we point out that reducing financing barriers to evidence medication use could lead to better outcomes and to reduce total cost of care. To what extent cost sharing may affect outcomes at cost is a question we will try to answer in this year 2017.